Grizzly Man, directed by Werner Herzog, was released in 2005.
I'm out in the prime cut of the big green. Behind me is Ed and Rowdy, members of an up-and-coming sub-adult gang.
It's a documentary that centers on this one guy, Timothy Treadwell, who went to an Alaskan state park every summer for 13 years to live with grizzly bears, and who, on the last of these excursions, was killed by one. During these trips, Treadwell took over 100 hours of footage, and most of the movie is just Herzog arranging and curating that footage, giving us a picture of what this person was like.
Bears do not have human protection, but are under human threat.
Herzog and Treadwell never met in real life, but the film acts as a meeting ground, a place for the two men to connect through the art of filmmaking. So that's this video, Grizzly Man, a documentary in conversation. Werner Herzog goes to great lengths to insert himself and his opinions into the documentary. And because of these insertions, we can see that this movie isn't just about Timothy Treadwell's wild grizzly adventure, it's also about the director and what he sees in that adventure. Herzog frequently compliments Treadwell's work, talks about how his footage brims with life and beauty.
In his material lay dormant a story of astonishing beauty and depth.
He dissects Treadwell, discussing his personality and motivation in metaphorical terms.
It seems to me that this landscape in turmoil is a metaphor of his soul.
He even explicitly disagrees with Timothy in this scene.
Here I differ with Treadwell. He seemed to ignore the fact that in nature there are predators. I believe the common denominator of the universe is not harmony, but chaos, hostility, and murder.
Where most documentaries place the director in an unseen place, somewhere in the shadows, Grizzly Man doesn't work like that.
When interference with nature was not enough, he had to invoke higher powers.
This film constantly returns to the author's opinions, his interpretations, and as a result, the movie feels intimate. There is no spotlight on the subject, just two people talking.
You're screwed, and all that.
Grizzly Man isn't just a conversation, though. It's a conversation about filmmaking. We can see this in one of the film's main themes, the notion of line crossing and boundary breaking. The tagline of the movie is, "In nature there are boundaries. One man spent the last 13 years of his life crossing them." And Herzog constantly brings the film back to Timothy's transgression of the border between the human and natural world.
You know, he tried to be a bear. He tried to act like a bear, and for us on the island, you don't do that. You don't invade on their territory.
Herzog places this theme throughout the movie, sometimes in really interesting places. For example, there's a tape that contains the audio of Timothy's last moments, a tape which could tell us exactly what Timothy and his girlfriend were doing and saying when they were killed by a bear. Yet Herzog doesn't include this tape in the documentary. Why? Because it crosses a line. Because
you would violate the right and the dignity of the death of these two individuals.
But the director doesn't really cut this tape out of the movie either. Instead, he listens to it and tells Timothy's ex-girlfriend that
you must never listen to this.
I know, Werner. I'm never going to.
He doesn't just not cross a line, he talks about not crossing a line. We can see this in a scene toward the end of the movie. Here, Timothy rants against the park services for enforcing rules against him.
As far as this fucking government's concerned, fuck you!
And Herzog says,
now Treadwell crosses a line with the park service, which we will not cross. He attacks the individuals with whom he worked for 13 years.
Again, Herzog didn't have to include this scene, or even mention that Timothy named the rangers he didn't like. But he did include it. He sees Timothy as a person who crossed a line, and he wants to respond to that, wants to tell the audience his take on the issue. The connection between Herzog and Treadwell, the cinematic conversation that this movie represents, becomes super interesting when we look at the way truth and fiction are played with here. Werner Herzog spends a huge amount of time addressing the inauthentic aspects of Timothy's persona. He mentions that although Treadwell's footage seems authentic, it was often the product of multiple manufactured takes.
But as a filmmaker, he was methodical.
Whatever.
Often repeating takes 15 times.
One more really short, excellent take.
He shows us that while Timothy claimed to have been alone in Alaska, he was often accompanied by his girlfriend.
The truth is that Amy Huguenard accompanied him for parts of his last two summers, a fact which was out of step with his stylization as the lone guardian of the grizzlies.
He includes this interview, revealing just how manicured Timothy's image really was.
After that, he was looking for a different persona. I guess that's when he came up with where he was from and his delightful accent.
And Herzog responds to Timothy's artificiality with artificiality of his own. Herzog's interviews have a deeply contrived feeling about them. Look at this scene where the mortician explains the circumstances of Timothy's death. Just as Timothy takes multiple shots of himself to get the perfect take, this scene was obviously shot multiple times, as it constantly cuts between a medium and a close-up. Also, this mortician's candor reeks of artificiality.
Amy stayed.
He's so weirdly upbeat.
Her lover.
So oddly stilted.
Her partner.
So aware of the camera's presence.
And with the bear.
And look at this scene where the mortician gives Timothy's ex-girlfriend a watch.
However, I want you to have this watch. I think that it is important that you have it. You knew Timothy for a long time. My understanding is that you lived together for 3 years. You were very close to him.
Yeah, he was my boyfriend for 3 years. He was my boss. He was a lot of things to me in 20 years.
The first time I watched this scene, I thought it was kind of silly. I mean, it's just so obvious that this whole interaction was choreographed by Herzog. But I've come to love it because of how it echoes Timothy's footage. It seems like this authentic, emotional scene, and it sort of is one. I mean, I find it pretty moving, but it's also an obviously staged event. It's a moment that exists only because of the camera's presence, because Herzog is making a movie. Here's another example. Toward the beginning of the film, Herzog says that there are only two times when Timothy's girlfriend appears on film.
Amy herself remains hidden in Treadwell's footage. In nearly 100 hours of his video, she appears exactly two times.
Yet at the end, he reveals that she was present a third time.
Did Treadwell wait till his last tape to put her in his film?
Timothy and Treadwell do the same thing. They both lie about his girlfriend. And where Herzog condemns Timothy for his line-crossing ways, he seems to sort of endorse Timothy's use of artifice. By echoing Timothy's contrived footage with his own contrived interviews, I don't think he's saying, look at this guy, he's a phony, so I'm gonna be a phony too. Rather, he's suggesting that when making a film, even a documentary film, we never have access to a perfect truth, some ultimate reality. Instead, there's always a story being told by the artist, and we might as well embrace that, both in Timothy's work and in his own work. Herzog says this himself in an interview.
Cinema vérité believes and probably is confused about the distinction between fact and truth. Facts are something very superficial, and they ultimately get the accountant's truth.
Werner Herzog doesn't think that facts are the ultimate aim of the documentary. He thinks truth is, and he sees truth in Timothy's footage, even though some facts are changed and some scenes heavily manufactured.
He captured such glorious improvised moments, the likes of which the studio directors with their union crews can never dream of.
So yeah, Grizzly Man isn't like other documentaries. Instead of trying to leave the director as some wordless presence in the background, this film centers the director, puts him in conversation with the subject of the film. And because of this, Grizzly Man is able to do much more than tell us about the life and death of Timothy Treadwell. The film is a meditation on the way films are made, a discussion about what it means to film someone, about the lines an artist should not cross, about celebrating the work of a strange, idiosyncratic man. Before anything else, Timothy Treadwell and Werner Herzog are filmmakers, and here, we get to see them talking. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I release a new video essay every Friday, and I'm always looking for new ideas, so if you have one, let me know. See you next time.